Hi, this is Vema Reddy. Today we'll see how we can work with JSON documents. So in with respect to Boomi, the Boomi Atom installation already provided with JSON library called org.json. It is a very easy library. It has only few classes. So using this, you can able to manipulate the JSON documents, like creating and parsing and extract and manipulate the documents very easily. So we'll just first we'll try to understand what is JSON and just what are all different types of available there. Well, after that we'll see how to create a JSON document, how to parse a JSON document and manipulate the JSON document and convert JSON array to serial. So first we'll let me open your sample document. JSON stands for JavaScript Object Notation. And JavaScript object notation is basically is a used alternative to an XML, and it's widely using in the it's been widely using in the APIs APIs. So there might be chances where Boomi when you have a like array kind of a structure here. So how the what and all different types of data types available there? So always JSON has a two data types. One is object. Object means the string. The string enclosed within the curl braces you can called as an object. So object can have a list of value pairs. So key value pairs. Each key and value is separated by colon and key value separated by a key value pair separated by the comma. So these are the object. So key always would be a string. Key always would be a string and you need to enclose it in double quotes. Key always will be a string, but value can be a different type. Value it can be a string, value it can be an integer. String always need to include in double quotes, and integers you know need to include in. And these are the primitive types: string, integer, and even you can specify the boolean true or value pairs. And date data type is not applicable in JSON. And after that, the value can be and another kind of JSON object, or value can be of type even array. Here you can see the value is locations here, and the value will be here locations of type array. Inside array, each again array can be each array item can be a string, array item can be a combination of a JSON object, combination of an array, again combination of primitive types, all possible will be there. So first we will see like how to create a document. So there are a lot of libraries are there. Jackson library is there, org.json library is there, even Google also, there is one more JSON library is provided. So but whenever you want to do in some kind of a custom scripting manipulation and Boomi, what you can do is you can use the inbuilt one. It means org.json library is already been presented. So let me go here and just see that Atom installation. You go to Atom management, you select the Atom name, go for install libraries. So you will see that there will be a default under the lib folder. This JSON library will be there. If you go here, you just type JSON, you can see that JSON.jar file is there. So using that, you need to, whenever you want to do something in custom scripting, you need to just declare the class files, import statement in the class name, and then that's all. You don't need to do any other thing. So let's say I have already created saving time. I already created the document for the. We already want to understand data types. Data type will be a JSON object, or it will be an array, or it will be primitive types. Always objects will be enclosed within a curly brace, and arrays will be enclosed within the square brackets, and rest of the strings always enclosed in the double quotes, and the integer you know need to put a double quotes. Boolean value, boolean, these are the primitive types. Apart from the boolean, string, integer and boolean primitive types, there is a two more things: object and array. All nested, you can value can be always key will be always string, and value can be all possible, as whatever we told just now. All will be possible combinations will be there. Okay, now let's see how to create a document. So in order to create a document, so I'm just using an Eclipse any point studio. I'm just using it's used for basically a design time tool for the MuleSoft. You can use any IDE tool. So whenever you're writing a custom scripting, it's better to always use the IDE tool so that it can be easy to debug, and after it to confirm everything is working fine, and then you can go ahead and put it back in Boomi. So first let's see that how to understand this one, and after that how to create a document and how to manipulate and how to convert JSON array to list. We'll see this one. After that, we will just try to put it into the Boomi. Okay, so first creating a document. Let's see that I have already imported the, let me go to Eclipse. So I have already imported the jar file here. So let's see that I have already imported this jar file. You can just try to understand what and all classes is here. So in order to create an object, JSON object, we have a class called JSON object. You try to understand the list of classes, main classes will be there. JSON object is the one. It is basically used to create the object and extract the data from an object. And after that, you can use the XML. XML is a class, basically you can convert the JSON object to an XML and XML to JSON vice versa. And other thing is a CDL, comma delimiter list. Whenever you want to convert any kind of CSV or CSV files to JSON object and JSON to CSV, you can use this one. And other one is whenever you want to convert headers to HTTP headers to JSON, you can use a header. It's cookie also similar to that. There is one more thing called property class. Property class also will be used to convert the dot property file list of value. Property dot property file, how it will be it kind of key value pair. Key is equal to name equal to value, some property name. Something like you can even use the property file to convert that. And even if whenever you want to deal with the arrays, JSON arrays, you will be using this one. So let's try to create the JSON. So if you see, just trying to create a JSON object, you use the control space, you get it JSON object. Okay, you just put JSON anything. Assuming that you have some understanding on the basic core Java concepts, you can see that JSON object is whenever you're creating a JSON object, you can see that JSON object can be taken a lot of basically you can call it as an constructor. It is a constructor. Constructor, why we use a constructor? It is, if you don't use a constructor, if you use the default one, this one, it will be a default initialization will be happen. But if you want to, at the time of an object the creation only, you want to use initialize the object, you can use a constructor. Construct nothing but you can pass some input to the object. Object creation. You can see that you can use a JSON token, tokener, you can use a map, you can use object, you can use a string, you can use one more JSON object. It mean even you can use a string. It means basically you can create a JSON object based on the JSON string, or you can create the automatically if you have an object is already instantiated, even you can create the object, and even you can use a map. JSON object and map both are similar. Map will also have a key value pair, name and JSON object also key value pair, but it is unordered, not unlist. Whereas a array is, it's a sequence of ordered list. So even you can see that whenever you want to create, you can use a, most of the things will go with either a map, object or string, depends on the availability of your data. So in this custom scripting, what I'm doing, I'm just creating a data with the default initialization. Because I don't have any data now, I just trying to create it. So it's just creating this line basically creates a JSON object. In this JSON object, I'm trying to add inputs like ID 101, a first name and last name, and like email. And I'm trying to create the list, because list will be, let's assume that this is a where the, this particular person has a person working history. You can see that I just passed the Bangalore, Hyderabad, Chennai. It means basically arrays.asList will be given as a list of values. So with this list of values, we are creating a JSON array. Because as I mentioned, JSON array is used, it's a list of values. It will be each string will be put in double quotes if it is string. And all this will be enclosed within a square brackets. So when you're creating a JSON array as well, you can see that you can pass the collection object string. You can pass the same thing. So with this, I created this, and for this location already have a list of values, and I'm just adding a put. basically put is used to add an key value pair to an object, and get is basically used to retrieve the key value pair from the object. They're the only two methods because it's follow very similar to the map. Map also will be using for put for adding the key value pairs into the map or object. Get is basically to retrieve that. So using the put, I'm just entering here. We put first argument will always be key and second argument will be the value. Because these are all primitive types, when it comes to second one for locations, it is an array element. That's why I'm creating an array. Because other than primitive types, you always need to use a respective type you need to create. After that, you need to refer it back in the here. So here I'm trying to print it. I'm trying to print it person. So by this time, I already created an object. I have already all the key value pairs has been added, and I can using the toString method. I can able to create the string. Using the toString method, I'm able to create the string. If you want your JSON to be pretty print, you can use the default value. You can pass it as a 4. With this, you will be able to create the JSON data will be created. After that, you want to convert a list of values to a string. CDL, as I mentioned here, comma distributed list, comma delimiter list. Basically, whenever you want to convert JSON array to comma separated values or comma separated values to arrays. So in this case, this is my array. So I'm trying to convert these arrays to comma separated value here. So using CDL row to string, I'm just trying to pass it. Okay, I'm just using this row to string. So it means basically converts the entire array. It takes an array, and this method will be returning. You can see that it is written of type string. It takes an array and it converts that to string. So now let me just run it here. So we'll see the difference. You can see that this is object has been converted to a JSON, and then after that I'm taking this array list, this JSON array, I'm passing it in this method cdl.rowString. It converts me. So if I want to use any object value, I can directly use the get method. So if you want to create a JSON object from a map, you can use that. You can create a map and you can list everything, and after that you can pass this map value to here. Using that, you can also create it. You want to see that, I can just let me comment out so that even we'll able to see the different set of input. Run it, you can see that two different set of JSONs will be created. The above one, I didn't add the. Locations, only the first name, last name added, and the remaining things automatically. And these two values come. So let's try to put the same thing in Boomi. How do you get? So I created a process. So what I am trying to do, I'm trying to convert this object to a plot file. But using the inbuilt option, we don't have an option to convert. When I am directly mapping plot file, the array element to here, you can see how it is getting created. So now let's go to build tab. I created already process. Let's review this process. Let's assume that though I don't have a process is being mapped here. So this is a JSON object. I created it here. You can just map the location value to here. Let's see how it generates it. Forget about the data process, because the data process I'm using some custom scripting to correct this issue. So let's see that how the value is coming now. Ideally, I'm passing only one object here. This object, I'll be expecting that first name, last name, location, all location name, I was expecting to create it as a comma separated values and put it as a one record. Because I'm passing only one object, I will be expecting only one row. But let's see how the data will come. You can see that first name, last name, email and location. But all values are same except this value. You can see, because it's getting iterated for every record, and we don't have an option to pass entire value. We don't have an option to flatten the particular array. So that's why what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to create the custom scripting here. What this custom scripting is doing, so in this case, I am passing JSON data as an in the message shape, so that it will come as an input document to my custom script. I wanted to retrieve this particular input document in the JSON. So how do you retrieve? So far earlier we don't have any input in JSON document to create it. I'm just using the default constructor. This time I will be using the string, because I already have the JSON document, all JSON document already coming to my custom scripting. So you can see that this is a creating, I'm creating, but I'm passing payload of type string here. How I'm converting that, because I'm getting input stream, right? This is a default values comes when I'm selecting custom scripting. So my all the JSON document will be there inside this input stream. This input stream, I wanted to convert this input stream to string, because I don't have an object, I don't have constructor, JSON object constructor won't take input stream. It only take the string, so that I need to convert input stream to string. So you can use a buffer reader and then construct that. Otherwise, you can use a simple common IO utilities. The common IO utilities, you can just pass this one so that it will convert, it takes input stream and returns the string. I am passing this string. So when you pass this string, what it will do, it validates the string and parses that, and from that it create the JSON object. What is my JSON object? This is my entire JSON object. Now what I need to use, I need to retrieve this value. Well, how to retrieve value? Using the get. This is a person. From this person, I need to get. Always I need to pass a key. Key is location here. So that my return type, what will be my return type? My return type will be of type an array. So because this is a default, it will give the object. So that's why we need to casting it. So we got the locations, and we are using the same function what we already used here, cdl.row to string. Only difference by from this custom scripting and from this Java code and this custom scripting is I am creating a JSON data directly here instead here in the custom scripting, Boomi custom scripting. I am passing the creating a JSON object using the JSON string by passing as an input to construct. So, and this will be giving me the output as a string. I'm capturing that output into an output variable, and then I'm using the, I'm dynamically setting the property called set dynamic process property using the function. Locations is a variable where it has all the data. And this is, we need to use it, reset it. If we don't reset, what happens? Because we are reading a stream right here. From this stream, it will read entire data here. And if you don't reset this data, so the data already been consumed, the data will not be available here. That's why we need to compulsorily, we need to reset it. After resetting, what is my output here? After process is been read, after this data process gets executed, it takes location data from this object, location data from this object, and this object is converted into comma separated value. This value converted into comma separated value, and that converted value is capturing into dynamic process property. I am referring the dynamic process property in the here. Let's go here. I'm just disconnecting and mapping it here. Let's see how it comes from. Let's see the output now. You can see that I'm encoding in all our single quotes. If I just copy paste this to Notepad. Yeah. Even if you want, we can even what we can do, we can trim the values if you want, because string we already have inbuilt functions here. We can directly trim the values if you want. So this is the way how we can use. So what we understand from here, so we understand how what and all different types of JSON types here, and we given options to create JSON document using the JSON string. You directly creating empty JSON object and populating the values, and from that extracting the JSON, and even showed how to use the map document also. After that, we pass the input document to the JSON document. We pass input to JSON document here, this input document, and we parsed it. And after that, we retrieve the values, location update. After that, we use an array. We created an array. From array, we convert it into a comma separated list. After that, we use a set property, dynamic set property, and then we converted it to capture the output value in dynamic set property, and we refer it in maps. So whenever you want to use it, any XML document you want to convert, so always you convert that to an XML to JSON, and JSON has a very good option where you can directly extract all the required values, and then you can store it in dynamic process property or document process property, and you can retrieve those values in the later. So this is how even you can, for XML also there is an library is there, DOM4j, but always XML parsing and it takes a lot of time, but JSON is will be very very easy to work with custom scripting even. I hope this helps. Thank you for watching this video.